All right, draft finals with Sultai control. I don't like this hand very much. The three most expensive cards in my deck, and no red mana. Is it a mulligan, though? Man, if I mulligan this hand, this is going to be like the first time ever I mulligan a 4-land, 3-spell hand in Limited when I have all my colors and mana. But I think my deck is really good, but it has a high mana curve, and if I just draw no cards that I can play before turn 5, I could lose with a good deck. Oh, man, can I just... I think, also with the card draw, I think I can just do better with 6. I'm going to mulligan, but I don't know. That's really borderline. I do think this hand's better, so I'm happy with the decision. Yeah, I mean, generally, I really strongly advise not mulliganing hands like that with 4 lands and 3 spells and Limited, but I think the combination of, like, a high level of confidence in my deck and having card draw to come back from the disadvantage just made it worthwhile. In other words, do as I say, not as I do. Alright, I like manifesting that and putting this on top. I will gladly block, and later in the game I can get my free value off the River Prowler. Sure, so... with Bitter Revelation in hand, my top priority is just trading off, making sure I don't fall behind on the board or let my life total get low. So I'm going to cast Glacial Stalker and just trade it off immediately. I don't need it to win the game. I can find other win conditions with the Soothsayer and the Bitter Revelation. Ooh, it's a good card. Really glad I drew a land there. I didn't want to have to Crater's Claws the morph, but I also didn't want to take a turn of not impacting the board. All right. I wonder if this is in the Freet Weapon Master. That's certainly the one I think of in Jeskai. So what to do this turn? I guess I'll Bitter Revelation. All right, let's just take the two giant creatures and try to kill them. Oh, Glacial Stalker, sure. Ooh, that's getting throttled, or perhaps blocked by Abomination. Hmm. which is better. Throttle is safer. I don't want to, like, take a bunch of damage while he plays removal spells, or, you know, God forbid he puts, like, Jeskai Rune Mark on it, and then I can't throttle later. But this is just safer. Whenever possible, I really love to just cast my morphs face up instead of first putting them face down and then spending a lot of extra mana to turn them face up. It's just an issue of mana efficiency. You spend less total mana that way. Green, blue, blue. Next turn, if he plays nothing, I'll probably attack with everything and whisk away the Glacial Stalker. Time Walk should be enough to put this game in the bag. So I'm going to say okay, I'm going to use my Abomination, and end of combat I'm probably going to whisk away. So if he has nothing, he's going to take another 5, 6... I guess I want to put the Mandrills in play, if nothing else, for the Ferocious on Crater's Claws. We'll definitely make sure that he's good and dead. Ooh, Monastery Mentor. Plus 5 from the unblockable. My opponent's deck is really, really good, though. I think I just had a really good draw that game. And who knows what could happen the next game. As of now, I don't see any reason to change my main deck configuration. Let's just run it again. Maybe the River Prowler is too slow. I'll board that out for game 3 if it comes to it. Ooh, Silumgar is probably really, really good against my opponent's deck. Oh, I keep forgetting about my decision to board in an extra swamp. I think I should have been doing that, but have been forgetful. Oh, what a draw. That's the draw of the century right there. I was like, oh man, I wish I had more answers to Monastery Mentor in my deck. I have to wait till I can throttle it on turn 5, and then I just drew my one answer. It's, when you draw like that, you can win a draft. You know, I actually maybe should have just cast Archer's Parapet this turn because my opponent's going to play a fifth land and attack, and I'm not going to be able to block because I saw Glacial Stalker last game, but I could block with the Archer's Parapet. So that was probably not the best play on my part. Yeah, I have to take it. I would love to trade, but it's too risky. Oh, wow. It's all falling apart because I didn't play the Archer's Parapet. All right. So I think damage control here, I just Crater's Claws the Morph and play the Archer's Parapet. And then if I can survive to cast these three cards, I will very likely win the game. My opponent's deck is excellent. Definitely blocking here. I think I'm okay just passing. There's no need. I mean, I could kill off the warrior, but there's no need to trade damage here when I have Enhanced Awareness and Bitter Revelation. Do I play the swamp? Yeah, I'd probably play the swamp just to get that point in with Archer's Parapet. It could matter. I guess it could also come up that I next turn decide to Bitter Revelation hit Necropolis Fiend and can't cast because I only have 2 black mana. I don't know. Both are small but valid considerations. Yeah, Silumgar, just the hexproof on it too is it's too much. It's so good. So I'm gonna have 12 cards in my library. Kind of just want the whisk away just for safety. Maximum safety. But I will play the Jungle Hollow. I'm comfortable leaving myself vulnerable to an attack this turn. It's just like so unlikely that my opponent could do anything against 3/5 toughness blockers. Oh, I believe I passed Warden of the Eye, the 3/4 flying that gives all your guys lifelink. I also think I passed I'm mixing myself up with the names, but I think I passed the 3/3 that gets back a non-creature from your graveyard, and I think I passed the 3/4 flying that gives your team lifelink. I didn't pass Flying Crane Technique, but that's a card that I should have on my radar at this point. I guess also End Hostilities should be on my radar. I do still have Necropolis Fiend in my deck. Alright, I think I can attack with everything and make the whisk away play. I don't think my opponent has anything in hand to get out of this situation. So if I can just break his draw step next turn, I should be able to win. And then I have him dead next turn between Silumgar, Archer's Parapet, and Throttling the Smoldering Ifrit. No blocks. All right. So 3-0 with Sultai control. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.